What's up, guys? Jason Cardamone here. I want to talk about goals, how not to do goals, how to set your goals, whether you should even call them goals, setting targets, outcomes. I want to talk about your next year. You know, here we are. I'm shooting this video on January 1st, and I'm in the middle of my target setting, my outcome setting process. And now, notice I didn't say my New Year's resolutions because I don't do that. I'm sharing this with you because I know most of the world, that's where our minds are at. And I want to introduce you a couple new ideas that you've probably never heard before. You may have heard like little pieces of it, but maybe never put things together in a full structure like I'm going to share with you. And the material I'm about to share with you, this is going to be concise to the point. I just held a workshop a few nights ago for a group of people that flew all around the world and asked me to call in and share with them. I've just spent 6 hours on step one, six hours on step one of what I'm going to introduce you to. And there's really like three main steps to it, maybe even like bonus step number four here. So I'm just going to go through it, guys. So this is about how do we bring into intention the life we're creating? Because you may have been like old school goal setting was like, you know, SMART goals, specific, measurable, attainable. Now, those are still good guidelines. You do want your goals to be measurable, because if you can't measure something, you can't tell whether you're going towards something or not. Even if you're measuring how you feel inside, like a happiness goal, how do you measure happiness? You don't check your bank account, you know what I mean? So keep those concepts in mind as we're looking at this. And as you're creating your life here, I want you to really consider these things. Now, I'm going to give you a framework of three main blanket areas. Now, you can break these down into 8 or 10 other areas if you want to. I'm going to keep it very, very simple because your brain works on simplicity. It doesn't work on complex. I'm sharing that with you. I'm a former software engineer. I know what complex. I launched rockets for Lockheed Martin. I know what complex looks like, feels like. I've done complex. I do it all the time. And our brains can only handle complex when things are very, very simple. So here's something super simple for you. Step one is take a personal inventory, take credit, take the wins, your peak emotional experiences, the moments, the things that moved you, and just remember everything that you've done over the last chunk of time. Now, you're gonna hear me talk in this video about times of like the past year. You're also gonna hear me share times about like the past 90 days, which that is a year to me. I've defined my year now. So I read a book called The 12-Week Year by Moran. It doesn't matter who it's by, it's The 12-Week Year. There's only one of them out there. And it's this whole idea of what if you just, instead of go for entire year ahead, what if you just focus on the next 90 days? Now I'm gonna show you how to combine all of these goal setting systems, because I've been teaching goal setting workshops since 2007. Literally, I've done it dozens and dozens and dozens of times. That's why people call me and ask me about, they fly in from around the world to celebrate New Year's together, and it's super inspiring what they're doing, by the way, and that even changed part of what I'm gonna teach and why I've spent 6 hours on step one of this process. I'm not saying you need to spend 6 hours or more, but I would also challenge you. Most people spend more time planning their annual vacation, if they're even blessed to get one, than they do setting their own life goals and their outcomes and what they're doing with their life. That's why I take this damn serious. I do this stuff every 90 days, not like this same 6 hours, because it's the first time I've done this, because I was inspired by those people that all flew in from around the world. I'm sharing that with you because I'm changing my stuff all the time. What you're getting is a process that's been, I've refined this dozens of times over the years. I've led groups of high-end entrepreneurs through things of this, and I'm super pumped to share this. So the first one, personal inventory, what have you done? So this board, what you got, none of this means anything to you. There's like 100 random words on here. None of it means anything to you. I did a 3-hour and 38-minute video for me, and yes, I am gonna post this if my software can handle a video that long. It's my longest video I've ever shot. That it was for me, it's part of my process here. And I went through that based on a previous 2 hours of cataloging all this stuff on the board. Then as I talked it out loud, because that's how I think, is to walk and talk, so I did it on video. that brought out even more things that weren't on here before. So what this is a collection of everything I did. Now this was the whole last year, 2016. There is a chunk of these things that were based on the last 90 days. And I'll share more with you about how you can process things over the last year or last 90 days. I would encourage you to do that throughout the year. Maybe once a year you do a big check the whole year, chunk things down like I'm going to share with you, and then show how to do 90 day chunks. So you have actually 4 years over the next year. So you have a 12 week year or 90 day. I love 90 day runs. So, because your brain, here's another concept. I know I'm not really jumping around, guys. I'm feeding you things you're going to need in steps 2 and 3 here. So this idea about if you measure your goals, here's why New Year's resolutions suck, and here's why people fail all the time. Why do most people about 15 to 20 days into January, why do the gyms, why do you go today on January 1st and like, I won't even go near a gym today because they're freaking ridiculous. Everybody across the world has set these resolutions. They know inside they're not, what's changed? Unless they do something different, nothing's gonna change. Because every year, I've watched this happen for decades. You go to the gym, it sucks to go there in January because everybody's there. Then by the end of January, beginning of February, it's thinning out. By like middle, late February, it's just like it is all the rest of the year. It's a ghost town. I mean, more or less, it's the same people, the same of us that always go there on a consistent basis. Right there is a major clue to you. Consistency. Those people aren't there about like some giant long goal. They're there like, what am I doing today in the moment? That's why shorter time spans work. And that's why you have to measure your targets and your outcomes on a smaller timeline. You don't check in once a year. I've done this before, guys. Make a new goal like, hey, I'm gonna make another $100,000 stream of income this year, or $250,000, whatever the income is, whatever the 10,000, let's say just to make 10,000 a month or even 10,000 flat will change, that's your goals, whatever it is. And I love to pick on finances because numbers are easy to like pick apart. So set a goal to make new 10,000 a month, let's say, this year. So that's awesome, all excited, you know, kick butt the next few weeks here. Some of us have even more willpower. We go maybe a few months and, you know, June, July comes. We're subconsciously aware we've only created like $500 a month and we're supposed to be at 10,000 by the end of the year. And it's like June, or let's say it's July 1st, half the year's gone. That we know that subconsciously, consciously, it's so painful. We're like, oh, dude, let's like not even think about that. So we don't. And then we continue on, and next thing you know, it's like, it's Halloween, it's the end of October, it's Thanksgiving, the end of November, whatever. We're looking back, and now we're at like, let's say we're at like $1,000 a month. We're supposed to be at 10,000. We have 1 month left or 2 months left to make another 9,000 a month. We know we're out. We're like, everything in our brain says, now you don't have to be out. It's completely possible. I've built from 0 to 80,000 in a single month within 90 days. I know what we are capable of is far beyond what we can comprehend, but you have a part of your brain that will look what I did in the last 10 or 11 months. I've made 1,000 per month and I'm supposed to be at 10,000. I can't believe, it's all about belief systems, right? So here's a way to really get those things going is you take it, the reason all this is all the positive things, the amazing things I did in the past year. Published author, got in magazines, spoke on stages, led master, like all these things I mentioned, like big things with my children, my family. So I lived through all that, and not only did I spend 2 hours just like living through it, then I talked about it on video for 3 hours and 38 minutes. I just finally checked the numbers now. So I just spent essentially 6 hours just of the most amazing moments of the whole last year. Is that worth spending 6 hours to look at the last 365 days of my year? Hell yeah. Do I have some like rush to like, I have to have all this stuff done because now it's already January 1st? Dude, I don't mess around with my life. I'm not gonna rush this process. There are years I've spent 2 to 3 days on my goal setting processes for those years. And what's amazing, those years, the cars I wanted to own and the income I wanted to have, the business. I live that life today because I put the work in. I didn't spend like 30 minutes on this, like just, oh, that's cool, and just rush off because I'm so busy to get. Dude, I have a ridiculous amount of things I'm excited to get done right now. But guess what part of my goals are? To be doing tons of videos, tons of entertainment in the videos, pouring tons of value out there. That's why I'm doing this video for you right now. This has nothing to do with me setting my goals. It's me sharing and just adding value to your life, because that's a huge part of my mission statement and what I am here to do on in the world. So you catalog everything. You have to figure out how to do that. I'll give you a couple frameworks. The first framework is categories and how to think about things, because some people's brains, we need ideas. We can't just blank slate, like rattle off things. Some of us can. Others of us, we have to have like categories that kind of jog our memory. So three main categories to think of: health and nutrition, fitness, physical, all that kind of stuff. Weight goals, that's a huge thing for a lot of people. Second one would be career, finances, business, money, entrepreneurship, that kind of thing. Third one would be relationships. And this, you can include fitting in this whole category: contribution, relationship to yourself, self-talk, personal development, your charity, your tithing kind of stuff, your church and religious and spiritual views. All that stuff can fit in there. Now, I rattle off all those subcategories, guys. I call them subcategories. I'm just giving you bigger chunks. Dude, you can totally go and have different categories for all your stuff. So I kind of did categories on my board of like people, you know, big accomplishments, overall themes and business kind of stuff, family stuff, and then trips. That's how it went. And then books and lessons and like those are. But I always think in those different areas are what's really interesting. The health and nutrition stuff really didn't appear on this board because it's just deeply installed part of my life. And I will throw in some more of that because I didn't have it in my martial arts goals when I did this process. So, which means I didn't complete the process even though I've already done 6 hours. So that, and the reason you do all this, guys, why we do this, it's so that you have a set of things to realize how amazing you are. Because when I saw this and I realized what I'd done over the last year, I was like, dude, that I did so much in this last year. Like way less, consciously, I was aware of like a lot of this stuff, like let's say half of it, consciously aware. But I wasn't even giving myself very much credit. I'm like, yeah, this is a pretty good year. When I went through this, I was like, dude, this was by far the best year of my life. I forgot all about these amazing things I had done, especially the stuff earlier in the year. So now I'm feeling amazing about what's possible, what I've done in the last year. Now we're on to step two, and that is to create, to brainstorm, to go through what we're gonna do. And I don't care if you do this with music. I don't care by the way, the more of this you do, the better you're gonna do. Music, dance around, move around. That's why I talk about walking and talking. I just discovered this literally 3 weeks ago. I've always known I'm the guy that like walks around pacing, talking on the phone. The way I think and my creative mind works best is when I walk and I talk, whether it's to myself for a video or to an entire stage of like a crowd of 2,000 people like I've done in the past. Whatever it is, I need to be talking to flesh out my ideas, not just sitting there in deep thought. And I do that as well, but I work way better talking out loud. So because I know that about myself, that's something I integrate. You might be a person, you sit down and journaling quiet, like that may be your thing. I remember the library, dude, I was in the library in college, guys. Here's just like, you need to know yourself. Here's how well I've got to know myself. I look back on my life with what I just shared you about walking and talking. I used to try to get my studying done in college, sitting in the library, which is supposed to be quiet, and every time anybody would talk around me, my brain couldn't help but hear them. Now, this wasn't the days of like this is so funny, this wasn't the days of like MP3 players and stuff. We had like freaking Walkman and crap back then. This is like the mid-90s. And it was so hard for me to focus and study. Even though I kicked ass in college, I was one grade and one class away from graduating with honors. So grade-wise, I killed college. But with all that said, I struggled. There was a lot of studying that didn't happen because I didn't know I needed to be like walking around. And I didn't know what I should have been doing is plugging in music without words that I would have been like studying genius master. And I studied fairly well, but there's tons of distraction because I didn't know that about myself. So with all that said, you need to find the ways that work best for you. So those same main categories, health and fitness, career, business, finance, entrepreneurship, relationship, spiritual, all that stuff. Look in those categories, feel those things out. What do they sound like? What do things look like and sound like? And play with the three modalities of what things look like: visual, VAK, auditory, number two. What do things sound like? What do you talk to yourself? What do you say to others? What are you hearing? What is the sound of the stream sound like as you're near camping near the river up in the mountains and the water is rushing by and it's just soothing all night long because it's this like noise in the background and you're actually, it's so loud and so overwhelming. You're not sure if it could like, if it just overflowed just a little bit, you'd just be washed right away and die. Like, dude, that I live that. And that's, you want to go to those levels of what you're creating. So if you're saying like, yeah, I want to make $10,000 a month, dude, why are you doing that? None of us care about money. You may think that. These $100 bills I carry on, this isn't about money. It's about me looking down, knowing what the wealth represents and that I always have wealth. Even when I had like no money in the bank, I was carrying around a couple $100 bills because it always reminded me, dude, I have money. I always have money. I always have money. Even when I literally didn't in the bank, like the last couple $100, my name was in hundreds of my wallet that I refused to spend. Even when I only had one left, I remember that. And I'm sharing all that because all that is just a representation of what do we do with the money? That's really what moves you. And does it give you the time freedom so you can go out and do the things you want to do? Do you want to do videos and speak and inspire people probably my favorite thing, my biggest purpose in the world? Do you want to go to an event every month, travel all around the world, hanging out with 6, 7, 8 figure income earners and getting even better than you already are and adding value to them and just like growing? Do you want to have a library like I do out there and have read hundreds of books and whatever it is, whatever that life is you're creating, and give the money to the people you want to give to, and including yourself and the lifestyle you want to create? That's what the money gives us. Those are the things you need to be focused on. And you do need to attach specific numbers. It's like, okay, we want an executive chef, which we still don't have, but we do have our house cleaner and these other people within our life, the yard, people that take care of our yard and everything. That all these things used to be just like, I didn't have specificity around it. Once we looked into all that, we started putting numbers on it. All of a sudden it's like, oh, we need an extra 400, 500, let's say, I don't even know. I think it's about $500 a month to have all of our yard and our house clean on a consistent basis to the standards we want our yard and our house to look. Where my wife or I don't have to be doing tons of dusting and cleaning a bunch of stuff, and we enjoy, like, that costs us about $6,000 a year, plus maybe $5,000 a year, somewhere in those ranges. So now that's specific numbers, but now I have a reason of like, well, what else can this $5,000 get me if it came down to that? Or an even better question, how many other chunks of $5,000 can I make to do all these other things as well as like do the education we want to be doing with our children and ourselves? And dude, my budget is way, way, way over. I mean, I spent like somewhere plus or minus $50,000 this year just on my personal development. So that alone is a little under $5,000 a month. Dude, that's like, looking back on that, that's amazing. And so just realize that those numbers, I didn't set out the beginning of last year and said, I want to spend $50,000 this year. That was not my outcome. And along the way, I stretched all these things and I did my first $10,000 mastermind in May this year, and it changed everything in my whole life. And I made more than 10 times that in the coming 6, 7 months since then. And that's just the beginning. In the years to come, it's going to be multiple seven plus figures. And I did that another two other times. That was a giant leap. I remember back my first product that cost $300. That was a huge leap of faith to buy John Reese's Traffic Secrets 2.0 back in, I think it was 2008. It's a big leap. That was like, dude, this is freaky. $300. Okay, I'm going to do it. And it was a ton of money to me at the time. So, but those are all, what are you looking to do in your personal development? So, and all the other areas as well. So you define all these areas of what you're going to, what you want to achieve and what you want your life to look like, and step into it and live it. And now you have to do a little bit of check-in. And I'm not going to go through future pacing and all this other stuff. If you know what that is, do that. But what you really want to do is step forward to the end of this year. Now we're still going to do the 90-day thing. That's going to be secret bonus four here. So step three is, so now step one, we've cataloged, we have a personal inventory of all these amazing things we've just completed. Step two is we've designed the next year of our life. And now step three is like, we really need to check all this because we've all set goals and targets. I remember a long time ago, I really wanted a Lamborghini many years ago. And over the years, it kind of dropped off the list. What really dropped off was my belief of how easy it is to own a Lamborghini. And it really is. It's super easy. It's a couple $1,000 a month is all you need. And so I didn't know that and I lost sight of it. And at some points in there, couple thousand a month became such a big thing to me. And so my belief system was like, oh, I just dropped the Lamborghini off. It literally didn't mean anything to me for a while, up until early this year when I drove one for the first time in my life. And that really brought it all back of how much I really did want that. And I just sold myself out on it. So that is something it absolutely will be, is a part of my year here. And so, and it has nothing to do with me like making video. I don't even know if I'll ever make a video. I probably will because it's so crazy and it builds people's belief so much. But that's not the purpose of me getting the car, is to like make videos and show off. Nothing to do with it. I don't care. In fact, I am more worried about the judgment of my neighbors and people I care about more than the show, I'm the opposite of that. I've been like that my whole life with nicer cars. Like, what are these people going to freak out? And I'm even way more in the past 4 or 5 years. I'm like, dude, I don't care. I don't care what people think. So we have an amazing SUV. So anyway, create those things. And now you got to check in. You need to step into the end of the year. And you can also do this in 90-day chunks. We'll talk about in bonus step four. So step three is, step in to December of 2017 or whatever year you were in now that you're seeing this video. Step in 12 months ahead. And by the way, here's another huge clue, guys. You can do this in June. You can do it in February. You can do it in September. You can do it on any random day, a birthday, or any random day that doesn't mean anything, but it really means everything because you're choosing. What matters as you're going through this process, it doesn't matter if it's January 1st or December 31st. That has nothing to do with anything. I'm doing this now because that's where I know most of the world is at, because I'm watching everybody's posts on Facebook and what people are doing all around the world, because I want to serve you with where you're at. I'm teaching you, you can do this all year long, anytime that you need to, and you're going to realize in step four, you do need to do this more than once a year. So you step forward, you check in with the goals you had created in number two. Goals, targets, outcomes, you need to figure out what those really mean to you, and I'll talk more about that too. So you check in, you step into it. Whatever car, whatever house you're creating, you go live in that house in the theater of your mind and your imagination. What does it feel like? Again, we're back to VAK, KAV. What does it feel like? Kinesthetic. I didn't even finish that before. VAK is visual. What do things look like? The colors, how bright, how near or far is it? The auditory, how loud is it? How consistent is it? How is it monotonous, Bueller, or is it amazing, dynamic speaking with different volumes as well as different cadence, where sometimes I'm super consistent with the way I speak and sometimes I speak much faster and then even change things and the intonations of my voice as I make commands. And I also ask you questions. And do you like it more like this or like this other way? Those are questions, commands, statements. Those are all things to do with auditory. Three, kinesthetic. How do things feel? Are they smooth? Are they rough? Are they prickly? Are they hot? Are they cold? Are they soft, hard? All of that is kinesthetics, how things make you feel. So you use those three modalities and you're gonna be more attracted to one or two of those than all three. One of those you're gonna be like, that's like drives you crazy. So one of them you're gonna love more than the others. So you go live into these targets and outcomes and goals with living them through those three modalities using your imagination, which this is why you need to become like a child again. Like, this is why it's cool to hang around children and why you should never grow up, because your ability to tap into your creative imagination, which we all have, and we all allow it to society to beat it out of us. Now you have to unlearn and retrain yourself back to what it really means. So you play in that, you imagine, you play, you have fun, and you live this life you're creating. So it's kind of like split testing it out. You're testing this life out like, do I really like this life I'm creating? And you're living it. That's why you don't do this in 10 minutes. It's why you take hours or days to do this. It's why you do it all the time throughout the year as well, which is step four. So the third part is you live into the goals you'd created, the outcomes, the targets, and you're really checking in. The why. I think Tony Robbins calls this the rocking chair test. You fast forward into the future. Did this thing really mean something to you as you're looking back on your life? Which is really, you can do this a year ahead. You can do it 5 years ahead. I just use a year because it's pretty simple. And feel free to do this 5, 10, 20 years ahead and look back on the impacts of this decision, of the goal you're setting and the intention you're creating for your life. And as you, before you're stepping into doing this and consistently taking action, which is part of 4 and 5, that before you're taking that consistent action, that you need to, like, dude, do you really want to go create a life of like, maybe you're like, I want to speak from stages around the world. And then you step into this life and you realize what it really is around the travel, around the speaking, around you actually have to be empathetic and care and love other people. And maybe that's not your default. You don't want to be empathy. You want to be like super entrepreneur and go make billions of dollars. Like, and be and guys, you can do both of those, by the way. You can be empathetic and be super entrepreneurial, make billions of dollars. I'm not trying to say you have to choose one or the other. I'm just saying that if, as an example, maybe you realize there's parts of speaking that you don't like. There, people will judge you. You will get hate mail. The more public figure you become, the more people are going to hate you. That's why I know people that actually are super, super, uber successful 9 and 10 figure earners that nobody knows about, because they stay super secret behind the scenes because they don't want to deal with that public crap that like actors and actresses deal with all the time. So, and celebrities. Like the paparazzi stuff, dude, that is a freaking nightmare. I've done a little smidgen of paparazzi stuff at an event, and it wasn't even paparazzi, it was just being slammed by like 1,000 people for an entire weekend. And there were parts of it that were just so amazing, and I love pouring into people. There were other parts of it, like they were sucking life out of me, where I didn't even get to hang out with my family and loved ones that were there, because there's so many people, and my family didn't want to interrupt. I didn't want to interrupt. It was like, we didn't know how to deal with all that. It was crazy. So I'm just sharing, amplify that by 1,000 times, and that's full celebrity. So like, there are consequences that go with any decisions you're making. So you want to step into that and live it so that you know, is this really what you're looking to create? And some of that you still, no matter how much time you spend on step three, some of it, that will weed out some of it. And then you can rework some of your stuff from step two here and create even better things that are more in alignment with what you want inside. So that's step three. Some of it you won't even discover until just going through the process, and you may be halfway through the year or a few weeks in, or maybe 12, you may be 2 years in it and you're like, dude, I didn't foresee this stuff. Like, and that's, those are all gifts to us. Those get us even more onto the path we were destined to be on in the first place. That's called personal development. It's called life. So step one, catalog all our great, great moments, make us feel really good about what's possible, what we've already achieved. Step two, create what we're going to do over the next year. Step three, live into that, make sure it's what we really want. Step four, and by the way, there is a step five. Step five is really an overall, like a little hack kind of a thing. Step four is chunk this down into 90-day runs. And so what you want to do, the simplest way to do it. Now this would be, if you have a very, very, I really do have a math degree and it's so funny. if you have a very linear income, not a geometric income where you're like building teams of people, and the more people you help build up, the more your income geometrically climbs. That model's a little bit different to build for than a linear income. In fact, I would encourage you just treat everything as linear anyway, like you're the only one responsible, which you are. But then, because you're also responsible for your leadership, and through leadership, and if you know how to lead and inspire and teach and serve people at the truest level, you can actually leverage other people's gifts and skills and time and money and all the amazing things and help them live even more of the life they want to, and leverage some of that where you get a piece of it, especially like in direct sales and network marketing type of industries. That's where geometric growth can like fly through the roof, where you pour into other people and it comes back like amplified. So that's harder to plan for though. So I just encourage you to treat everything like a linear income. So let's pretend like we want to be making, here's very simple numbers, I'm going to keep it way simple. We want to create a new stream of income of $12,000 a month. Why did I choose 12? Because it breaks down into 12 months easier than 10. And I don't want to talk about $8,333 or whatever. That's not even the right number. I forgot the right number. And now my brain's like, wait, what is the number? It's 8,167 or whatever. Like, we're not doing that. $12,000 a month. Break that down. What it means is every month we need to make a new add on a new $1,000 a month. So it means by January 31st, I need to be making a new $1,000 per month. That's going to last for the whole rest of the year. Then by the end of February, I need to figure out how I'm now making $2,000 a month. So I take that first $1,000, I add on another $1,000. Now I have $2,000. By the end of March, I add on another $1,000, $3,000. Break down my goals throughout the year. I did it monthly for you guys here. So what I really want to look at is 90-day chunks. So here's what I'm going to focus on January 1st. I could care less once I'm through this whole process. Now this is part of step five. It's really 4.5, I should call it. So you break things down into these 90-day runs, these 12-week years, these 90-day years, and you literally train your brain. You don't run your life on a year schedule, because January 1st doesn't matter. You run your life on a 90-day schedule, and they don't have to start on the traditional quarters of January 1st, April 1st, July 1st, October 1st. You don't even have to do that. That's the traditional business world, and there are even companies that don't even base their taxes on that. They're off-centered by weeks or months or whenever they choose their date. You can do that when you're forming companies. So you can do this anytime, any day. So I don't care when you're seeing this video. Like, it doesn't matter. When you're seeing this video, you can do this literally today. For the next 12 months, the next 90 days, you can start. I do that all the time. I am right now getting on a schedule where 90-day runs are coinciding with quarters throughout the year. I am not afraid to change that at any time. In fact, I've already changed that at least twice last year. I've recalibrated my 90-day runs. I've been doing 90-day runs for, I think, a little over a year and a half, somewhere in those ranges, and they've changed a lot. It's why I just had another of the best years of my life, but dude, I did. That's amazing. So you break it down into 90-day chunks. So what I'm worried about on January 1st is my next year, which is the next 90 days, which is between January 1st and March 31st. What that means is, if we're just, guys, this is just income. You have to do this for every single category, and not just a category, because how the hell, where's this income coming from? Is this one income stream? Is part of it from my job, and I'm going to be doing more things there and getting more responsibility? And, or am I completely, is part of this, I'm getting out of my job, and that's the reason? Like, whatever it is, you have to do this for every area of your life, including your personal development, including your fitness and health and nutrition, and everything, your relationships, date nights with your spouse, with your children, with your parents, all of every single part of this. So all I'm focused on is, what am I doing between now and March 31st? Now the reality is, today is day one of my next 90-day run, and I will be spending all of day one and two on creating the rest of my year, because I've only done step one so far for this run here. And it's because I love teaching so much content, and this is a huge part. I also have a bunch of loose ends that I will be tying up. I have piles of things that some of them have been sitting for 2 years, and I'm ripping through everything and trashing, filing, deleting, and giving away every single thing. So that's going to take me, plus the rest of my steps 2 and 3 and 4, that's going to take me the next couple days. So I'm investing the first at least 2 days of my 90 days into this very process. Most people do this at the very end. I just didn't do the timing right, and it's just how it worked out. I chose to hang out and hang loose with family a little more. So I did a lot of this stuff on day 90, but now some of it's bleeding over to day 1 and 2. I'm not worried about that, dude. This is essential. It's more important than anything I'm gonna do on any of the 90 days. This is the most important stuff. So all of it, step 1, 2, 3, 4, and 4.5. So step 4 is you break it down in 90 day chunks. So I'd only be focused on, am I going for, I'll just throw all of step 4.5 and 5 into chunk 4. It makes the most sense there. So I'm only focused on back to our income goal, 1,000, 2,000. I need to be making 3,000 a month by March 31st. That's my target, that's my outcome, that's my goal. How am I gonna do that? It's all broken down. Now I break down my next year, my 90 day chunk here. I break down these 90 days even into weekly and daily and even more. I would encourage you that the more, here's the deal. This is why I was referring to early on in the video where I talked about, yeah, you go a whole year and you want to be making $12,000 a month and it's Halloween and you have 2 months left and you're only making $1,000 a month and you're $11,000 short. I know the example was a little different, but now it's this example we're using. So with all that said, we've all done that. That only happens when you're not tracking quarterly, and you really need to do it even more. Monthly, weekly, hourly, daily, hourly, the more you can do. So here's where you bust out things like calculators, and this is not just the math geek, but every time I break numbers down like this, a lot of people are like, dude, I never thought of things like that. This is how your brain works. Can your brain comprehend exactly what 3,000 a month looks like when you're at zero today? Maybe. Do you know exactly how many sales you need? Do you even know what you're selling? Do you know exactly how many you need? And do you know what the systems and everything need to look like and your life needs to look like? Your time commitment, your financial commitment, your energy, your emotional commitment. Do you know what all of those and the people and the mentors and books and everything, knowledge you need, the skills you need, do you know what all that looks like to make that 3,000 a month? And if you're not 100% dead confident with knowing exactly and be able to live that right now, you're not gonna get it. That's why you have to break things down even further, because your brain works on specificity and finite things. We are being specific, 3,000 a month, March 31st, super specific. But now, are we specific? How many leads do I need to get that? Now, if you have some awesome systems and things like I use, you don't need nearly as many leads or traffic, or you don't need to pay as much or put as much time in as anybody else in the world to make that same kind of amount. But I'm not here to pitch you on my stuff. I'm here to like give examples of like, I know my numbers to make 3,000 a month. I know exactly what it takes. And in fact, for me, it's less than one sale, which is like, dude, really? You make more than 3,000 a sale? Yes. So, and I didn't start like that. Back in the middle of this year, I was making about $1,000 a sale. And now I've structured things in a way where now I make way over 3,000 per sale. So I know to make a new $3,000 a month by March 31st, which would be 3,000 plus 2,000 in February plus 1,000 in January. That's 6,000 new income. Oh, look at how I'm breaking the numbers down. This is 6,000 overall income by March 31st. I need to make basically a sale and a half in my world. I'll call it 2 sales. So I need to make 2 sales over 90 days. Now my brain's like, freaking super easy. I've done 3 sales in a day. I think I've done more than that, but that's just an example. And that's only me. I'm ignoring everything else, the teams I built, the systems, everything else happening. So I'm giving you an example of breaking down these numbers. You guys see how I'm doing that? I haven't even gone into weekly, monthly, daily, all this stuff. So let's break down $3,000 a month by March 31st. What does that look like per week? So 3,000, I'm actually just gonna treat it like it's exactly 12 weeks. It's actually closer to 13, but I'm gonna divide it by 12. $250 a week. That is not hard. $250 new dollars. Now, it's all about your belief system. That's freaking ridiculous. That's nothing. That's me, like I push a button and bam. I just created thousands of dollars of residual income in a couple hours the other day. That was, by the way, I think that was a new record for me. So that's cool. I need to throw that on here. And I forgot. That's just a secret code for me, because I don't need to be talking about everything. The details don't matter. I just realized that's something else I did last year, and that's a new thing I had never done before. Super awesome. Gonna really help a ton of people with that project. So so we break down the 3,000, it was 250 per week. So we need to make a new $250 per week. Now, what we do is break that down again by how many days are in a week? 7 days. Now, let's say you are designing a life that you're only going to put in Monday through Friday and not anything on the weekends. That's not really what entrepreneurs do, so I'm not really going to entertain that. I will say, especially if you're working a corporate job and you're trying to build a business, you need to sacrifice something, and it's going to be more than, you know, a random Saturday. Like guys, soccer is one of my biggest passion, coaching, teaching, serving people. I gave up coaching a soccer team two different times over the last four or five years. On two different occasions, that's a major, major sacrifice I chose to make for my community, for my own children, for other people's children that I very much cared about. I made that because there were many thousands of more people's lives I had to impact in a different way than teaching soccer to kids. And it was teaching exactly like this video I'm doing right now. But I couldn't do all of it. I couldn't go run multiple practices and run games. Even though I knew I was the best coach those kids will probably ever have in their life. They'll be very lucky if they get and this isn't even just about soccer. It's about the psychology side, which is way more important than anything. And it doesn't hurt that I played soccer for 30 years. But you guys understand, like, that's a major sacrifice that meant a lot to me. You mean even more to me. And it's not that kids don't mean a lot to me, that I had to find other ways, like with my own kids. The other children, I don't really get to coach and work with them anymore unless I know some of them actually do see some of these videos on Facebook and YouTube, which is, that's amazing. So my life's even better now. I didn't have to let all of them go. I know some still pay attention to some of this. It's really a huge blessing. So we break it down even further. We have 250 per week. I'm going to divide it by seven. So because there's 7 days in a week, you may choose to do like Sunday fun day, like I know friends. You may believe that Sundays are completely, completely unplugged, 100%. I will tell you, it's been my experience that the people who tend to feel like they need one full day a week off usually don't achieve as much as they really can throughout their life. But also, I'm not saying don't ever take a break. I am saying, like, you do need to unplug, sprint, and recover. So I usually call these 90-day sprints. So you can sprint for 12 weeks and then recover for like a whole week instead of just one day per week. You have to figure out what works for you. This is just how, like, this is, again, you have to know yourself when you're breaking all these down. So break it down however it's your life, you create it. Maybe you want to work one day a week. So it's $250 a day and you work one day a week. It's also $250 a week. So I'm going to divide that by seven. $35.71 a day. That's how much new residual income I need to create every day. So if I'm selling a product that I make $35 from every month, then I need to sell one new of those every single day, 7 days a week to be on track. I sell a new one every day this year. So look at this, $35.71. We multiply that by 365 days. This better be close to 12,000. We're actually at $13,034. And the reason that's so far off at 12K is because the mistake in the math was that there's not really 12 weeks in every 90-day chunk. It's actually, you need to do, you take the number multiplied by 52 divided by 12, I think, something like that, to get the real number, and then multiply or divide by another number. And I know some of you guys are complete, like, you just shut off the video, like, that's too bad for those that did. I'm not going into that deeper math. I'm saying there's not exactly, in 12 weeks, it's 7 days. I mean, guys, run the numbers. 12 weeks, 7 days in a week, that's 84 days. We're 6 days short. The difference between 84 and 90 is the difference between 12,000 and 13,000 percentage-wise. That's why you just saw that turn out to be 13,000. Here's another little hack I use. Always be conservative, always overestimate. So I would actually set the goal to make $35 new a day to create 12,000 by the end of the year, because that really is on track to help me make 13,000. In fact, I'm usually way, way, way more conservative than that, which means I'm gonna be setting targets for me to make 15 or 20,000 by the end of the year, when my real goal is 12,000, which means I have to hustle my, so I'm always overextending everything. I'm always pushing the limits, and that's why I tend to, like, I get goals, like when I made that $80,000 in 1 month, and I did it within between days 61 and 90 on a 90-day run. And I completely didn't believe I could do that. It was amazing. But that also well overshot anything I ever dreamed or believed I could do, because I set gigantic goals and then I go to smash through them. And I always work things conservatively so that when I do, even if I'm shy of hitting my numbers, I tend to hit them anyway. I'm like, whoa, I didn't quite get where I wanted to. And you always have to stretch yourself. If you're not stretching, if you become comfortable, you're either growing or dying. That's it. So same thing with comfort zone, personal development, everything. You're either growing or dying. So there is no, like, living this perfect, consistent, same life every day. You can't do, it's not possible. That means you're dying. You're on a downswing, not an upswing. So I'm sharing that because that's a huge part of this stuff. And that ties into the remaining part of number four here, is that you need to, the more you're measuring your targets, your outcomes, your goals, and literally measuring them, and they're in your face, they are like, here's a great example of something, my 90-day deal that I had set at the beginning of this 90-day run, marketing and funnels, power hour. I didn't quite hit that every day, but I did that more than I've ever done that. Optimal intensity with fun training, totally. All my fitness picked up big time. Four liters of Kangen water. I didn't quite hit 4 liters a day, which is crazy because I've been at 4 liters for like years. That one is actually under. So, but look, I'm aware of this because I saw this every single day sitting there. Family adventures and date nights, absolutely, we stepped that up big time. Daily gratitude meditation, check. That I did that probably better than I've ever done. Purpose-inspired videos and content. Wow, look, I'm doing it right now. So, guys, that, now an example of where that failed, now that paper, to be honest, that was under another piece of paper, so I didn't look at it every single day, and that's part of why that 4 liters started to fall off. Even though I was aware of it, I wasn't, There would be times my conscious mind, I know I have an intention to drink more than 4 liters every day, right? Especially the days I work out have to be 4 to 5. The days I don't work out, they can be 3. So, which is super rare. So that's why it's 4 liters a day. Which a sub part of that is that I work out every single day. So I'm sharing that because the reason why that one I fell short on, and even the top one, the marketing and funnels, my power hour, I didn't hit my power hour every day because I didn't hit those things because they weren't in my face. They weren't in my radar, my consciousness, and I didn't install them at a deep enough level when I created those to where, yeah, when I'm refilling water, I'm like, oh yeah, this is like my second liter, or my third of today or whatever it is. I'm aware of that. But then there's no trigger of like, my trigger used to be every hour I'm checking in all these other different systems and patterns. So I need some kind of a system and pattern. It doesn't have to be right in your face, guys, or somewhere where you're even going to see it. You just need to create routines and patterns and sink yourself in to, like, you're basically programming yourself. So one of the ways I've always programmed is I set 50-minute timers, and when the 50-minute thing goes off, or the music turns off, or the bell turns on, or whatever, depending on the timer system that I'm doing that moment, that I get up, do quick stretching, maybe a little foam roller, some oxygenation, refill my water, which is, I haven't been doing those 50-minute chunks at all for the last 90, so that's why a lot of those fell off. So, a lot of them. That's why 2 out of 6 weren't I didn't live as much as I could have. 4 out of 6, I freaking nailed it. Super awesome. So guys, that is the more, so to finalize number 4 there is, you want to measure things. The more you can throw things down on a spreadsheet, hold yourself accountable. If you can do this with other people and you're holding each other accountable, this is like, it's fantastic. It's such an amazing way. We are wired that when you physically sign your name on something or you hold yourself accountable publicly, you are way far, the studies are across the board, way, way higher percentage that you're actually going to hit your targets. And when you stop holding yourself accountable or you stop having a coach that holds you accountable, that's part of why coaching works so well. That's why you should have a coach in several areas of your life. If you need a coach in entrepreneurship and business, things like that, contact me. I'm actually not doing any personal coaching. I will be doing some different group things. I am coaching. All my time coaching is all going into my GAZ family. So if you're already in there, dude, you're in. Like that's a major focus of where the majority of my energy and focuses are going. So anyway, that's a version of getting coaching. And you need to hold yourself accountable. And the more you can measure these numbers every single day is best, and check in with your goals. So by the way, guys, at the end of 90 days, now you evaluate everything that happened over 90 days and you recreate all this. And I may not go through a process this deep at a 90-day mark. I'm going to do this again next year. This is amazing. And this was inspired by a group of young adults who all flew out to the East Coast from all around the United States just to work on the end of the year wrap up and creating their 2017. Dude, that was so inspiring. I've never heard of anybody doing that. That's amazing. So love it. And so that inspired me to really put this part even deeper, which also means I'll probably go even deeper into steps 2, 3, and 4 here. Like, because I've gone way deep in those steps before. I've never gone this deep in step 1, not even close. I've never spent more than like 10 or 20 minutes on step 1. Now I just put in 6 hours and I'm going to do a huge blog post on it and all this other stuff. And now we have this video that I want to share with you guys. So I'm going to run through the 4 steps as we're ending out this video and as you're stepping out to go create this and make the perfect ideal life where your unique gifts inside, using even more of them and discovering ones you didn't know you had and amplifying those you discover and that you already know about and making the world a better place and ripple impacting throughout everybody. You're going to hear me say that hundreds of times over the coming months. And so step 1, catalog what you've done even throughout your life, your peak experiences. I chose to do it just over the last year right here, because it also helped me to realize what I can achieve in one single year. So that was really cool for me. I've done this before where you'd like grab moments throughout your whole life. I've done that hundreds of times now. So I have hundreds of moments throughout my life that I grab and I'm adding new ones all the time, installing them and getting them in my system. So cataloging these peak emotional experiences, realizing what we can do within a year. Number 2, creating our intentions, our outcomes, our goals. What do we want to do? And we do it in the main chunks. The chunks of we filter things through visual, auditory, kinesthetic. I explain that. I have entire videos that explain. In fact, I'm going to be relaunching Jason's video tips. You'll see that it's not live right now. It's only to founders that joined months and months ago, and it's been shut off since then. I have a kick-ass training in there about visual, auditory, and kinesthetic. That alone is worth the price of all of the other modules in the entire thing. So, plus the other ones, I can say the same thing. It's my very best content of my life. So, visual, auditory, kinesthetic. There, I also did a Facebook Live on these that I went into them like to a small amount of depth. So, you process all these things through that, and the areas you want to think about is health and nutrition, career, business, finance, relationship, spiritual, contribution, and VAK. Then step 3 is now we use VAK, and when we're stepping and we're living these things today as if we're at the end of the year and making sure it's things what we're attaching our why. Why do we want to do this? Why do we want the money? Why do we want the body? Why do we want the fitness? Why do we want the belt in karate? What does that really mean? Is it just like, and be honest, is it like an ego thing? Like, be honest about that stuff. If that's just like, you have to be honest with yourself. Like, if you're not, you'll never like really even come close to your full capacity. You have to be congruent not just with the words you're saying to other people and the way you live, most importantly, the words you're saying to yourself and how you really live. And I know so many people not being congruent with either one, external or internal communication. So step three, stepping into those things. Step four is then break things down into chunks. Because I don't want you to go to all the trouble of breaking things down into smaller 90-day chunks and even smaller if it's the wrong goal, which you'll discover in step three. And if it is the wrong one, then you go back just in that area and recreate the things you want to in that area. By the way, guys, you may have 10 things that you want to do related to the areas of health and fitness. There may be weight-related things. There may be certain races or events you want to do. There may be new activities you want to integrate. You may want to make even more fun. You may want to find new coaches in that area. That's five alone. I could keep going. I didn't even spend time on this. So that is just health, fitness, and nutrition. You may want to hire a chef or be able to cook or understand better food. You may need to educate. You have to educate yourself with everything you want to do. So you may need to learn a lot more about health and nutrition so you know what you're putting in and you know what's going to produce the outcomes you're looking for. So I know people that have no clue about that and they're shoveling stuff in. They're like, it is not what their body needs to try to get what they're trying to do because they just don't have the education. And so anyway, so you go through the steps. So step four is once you have all your things set and you know they're all the right ones, now you break them all down into 12-week years, 90-day runs, and you break them down even further so that every 90 days you're chunking it and you're making, and then you go through a mini version of this entire process every 90 days. And I guarantee you the best year of your entire life for those, that one, for you that you're still listening and you know you can feel it inside and you're like, you know you just learned something here and it just sunk in deeply in a way that you haven't previously felt before. Maybe the chills ran up your back in a certain way. Or as you're really envisioning your future at the end of this year, realizing you just saw some of the things you've been missing this entire time. Or maybe it was the way that I said and I walked through certain specificities throughout this process that really, it just sounded like it was finally the right decision and the right thing you needed to hear in that moment. And whatever those things are, however you took all that in, for that, if that's you and you know I'm speaking to you right now, you can easily create the best year of your life. No hyperbole. Like, I know I freaking just did it. And in fact, I messed up one of my 90-day runs completely. The second one this year, because I didn't do one between April, May, June time. That's also right before this giant catalyst that happened for me in May. So hope you got massive value out of this, guy. Share, if this provides value to you, like share this. I don't know if this is on my blog. I have no idea where this video is going to be everywhere. So wherever this is, if this provided value to you and you think this will help other people, especially as we're all here creating and in this mode of, hey, it's New Year's Eve, resolutions. This is the truth of what people need to know. So I hope you got massive value. Please share this video. I am here to impact tons of other people. That's why I'm not putting in links and pitching and all this other stuff. If you got value out of this and you want to share this with other people because you want to provide that same value to their life, and now they'll be looking at you, they're not going to give me all the credit, guys. This is how this works. They're going to remember you for referring them to the person and the material and the expert that just helped them change their entire life. They will give you credit to that. In fact, I've had that happen to me, and people invite me to events for free. Big events, like I got to go to a Brendon Burchard event from this very thing. I recommended some Brendon Burchard material. I had no idea anybody had taken me up on this. This one gentleman, Stephen, loved you, dude. This was such an amazing surprise, and it's helped me. It's this ripple impact I'm always talking about and how it ripples back, too, because it doesn't always ripple back in the same way you think it will. This one happened to ripple back. So he went off and then he paid for one of Brendon's most amazing programs. And then he had a partner ticket for free, like a business partner. And he brought me to that event with him. I went to this event for free. I just had to pay for airfare. I don't even think he let me pay for hotel. I forgot if I ever won the battle of if he let me pay for some of that. But that all happened for free because like a year before I recommended one of Brendon's books and he loved it. And then he dove deeper in that world. I got the credit for referring him to the guru and the expert. you can do the exact same thing and it will ripple impact. And it may not even be through that person. It might be through other people. It's just how it works. And that's where you have to have faith around things. That's why I always add more value out in the world than I try to take away. Because I don't try to take value. I want value out of the world and out of the knowledge and skills and people and books and everything else. That comes after my primary thing, add value out in the world, because I know it always comes back amplified. It's just how it works. And I get to bless millions of lives in the process. I love it. So as we're all stepping in to create the most amazing year of our entire life, and as you know, that feeling deep inside and that vision you have for your life, and you know you just sounded like exactly what you needed to hear, you realize as you're stepping forward into this and you're looking back on this process you just went through, and as you're looking back from step one and all the things you created over the last year, and in fact, throughout your entire life, everything you need is inside of you right now to discover even more unique gifts you have and amplify those gifts you discover and the ones that you are creating and you're already aware of, and maybe you've been afraid to use, but now it's time to step up and use them. And as you're stepping out those gifts and sharing them with the world in your unique way, which is going to be different from my ways and anybody else's ways in the entire world, as you do that, your whole life becomes better and you step even into more of the best version of yourself. And as you're stepping into the best version of yourself, you're impacting even more people in your sphere of influence. And as you're ripple impacting people in your sphere of influence, the ripples flow out right through them to other people, and you'll touch people who never even knew about because of the decisions you made to step into your unique gifts. And as all those ripples are going out all over the world, the most beautiful thing is that these ripples are also coming back and they're impacting you and me, and we're ripple impacting between each other. And throughout all of this amazing process, because we have the confidence and the cojones to step in this and make some things happen and to not settle for our comfort zone, because we know that's dying, to always be expanding that comfort zone, expanding our gifts, discovering more, learning more, pouring more value out, giving more, loving more. And as we're doing all of that, the entire world is becoming a better place, and not just the world around us, because the world around us is all about our own perception about what we're seeing, hearing, and experiencing and feeling. And because of that, that's why, as we are creating these intentions to step into the best year of our entire life and gaining even more confidence knowing we can do that, that's why we are already doing that right now. And that's why you're experiencing all these things. And now it's time to then the videos, you step in and take the action and go make the things happen. Reach out. I'm here to serve you. I love you. Share this if it added value. I appreciate you, my friend. Let's go do this. See you soon, guys.